guys. We are going to bring your next comedian to the stage. She was born in Abbotsford, British Columbia. Absolutely. She's living in Vancouver right now. Please welcome Paula Antil.
I'm Paula Antil. I'm originally from Abbotsford, now living in Vancouver. And I want to sleep with a Vancouver Canuck. I knew I wanted to be a stand-up comic the first time I got on stage. And it's great to not have the pole anymore. I would describe my stand-up style as being pretty egocentric. If it's not about me, I don't usually want to talk about it. My inspiration for my material basically comes from how bad I am at my life. The greatest stand-up comic of all time is Bob Newhart. I mean, he is hysterical, he must be, because I do want to sleep with him, and he's not pretty. After a bad show, my drink of choice is a big pint of self-pity, followed up with a big slice of pity cake, and then pity sex. I'm gonna win this competition because I have dual citizenship. I'm half American, and, well, that just makes me better.
Hard mic. Yeah, it was a hard mic. That's actually a good start, so that's okay. I live in Kits now. Yeah, Kitsilano. I don't want to brag. I don't. It's nice, right? It's nice. But I don't want to brag, but I do have the hottest hobo living in my parking garage. He is so hot. Oh, my God. Like, whoo. Not his face so much. His face kind of looks like an apple that's been left out in the sun all day. But his body, oh my God. He looks like Ned Flanders when he takes his shirt off. And he never has his shirt on. I don't think he owns a shirt. Oh God, just cut, you know? Like, if you were to lick his abs, it would be like rubbing your tongue up and down chiseled garbage. Yum. I would never have sex with him. I wouldn't. I mean, I could never fuck him better than life has already. And I'm not that promiscuous. I grew up in Abbotsford. It's hard to give a guy a blowjob when you've been told Jesus is watching. Hard, not impossible. I moved into Vancouver. I found a roommate on Craigslist, which I recommend if you don't like your stuff. And I moved in, I didn't know her. We were sitting around one day, we're talking about New Year's resolutions. I'm like, I'm gonna quit smoking. And she says, I'm gonna stop having one-night stands. I'm like, oh my God, how huge of a whore are you? And I'm gonna stop using your towels. Yeah, no, I mean, I get one-night stands. Like, sometimes they just happen, you know? Like, I'm on a first date, and I'm like, oh my God, you're so boring and awkward. I never wanna see you again. So I'm gonna have to sleep with you tonight. Right, ladies? Right? No? Just me? That's cool. No, everybody knows if you sleep with a guy on the first date, he's never gonna call. It's just my way of setting him free, you know? But just to make sure, on his way out the door in the morning, I'll yell after him, hey, I love you! Trust me, he doesn't call. I've tried it like a million times. Oh, man. Growing up in Abbotsford, it wasn't easy, though. My mom would buy all my clothes from a secondhand store, the MCC. That's the Mennonite Community Center. I wore the discards of Mennonites to school every day. Yeah, I got beat up a lot. And to make matters worse, my last name is Antil. So, of course, all the kids called me Fuckface. Yeah. I had someone do something really romantic for me just a couple weeks ago, and I'm still kind of like happy about it. He sent me a Facebook event invite, but I was the only one invited. And it was an invitation to an evening of sitting on his face. So I replied, maybe attending. I didn't want him to cancel the whole event if I wasn't coming. You know, he'd gone to so much trouble. I was a little bit confused. I mean, I'm the fuck face, so... That's dirty. He was over at my house. He's just over at my house because, well, he's a friend. And he found this photo of me. And every girl has a skinny or a sexy photo of themselves somewhere close at all times so we can look at when we have low self-esteem. And he found my sexy skinny photo. And he's like, is this you? And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, really? And I'm like, yeah. And then he took it to the washroom with him. And I was so mad. I was like, I pound on the door and I'm like, oh my God, just tape it to the back of my head. It's still me. Oh, thank you guys a lot. You have a good night.
Paula Antil!
It was okay in bits, and then I was a little sloppy in bits, and at last minute, I improvised a joke, and it didn't work, and I was like, oh, that was so stupid. I pulled it out. Oh, that sounded dirty again. I think it was the stuff about talking about one-night stands. I think that was the stuff that went over the best, I think. It was a really dirty set. Oh, I had so much fun, and I'm really close friends with a lot of the comics, so it was good to hang out with them. So it was a fun hangout night. I might get a little drunk now, actually, and then drive to Squamish, but after I've sobered up.